If we are monitoring our athletes, it's important to try and understand the physiological cost of their training program on their body. We do this by trying to quantify internal load, and indeed, heart rate TRIMP, training impulse, is one of the critical ways that we can do this. Hi, I'm Joe Clubb, founder and sports science consultant at Global Performance Insights. And today in this video, in collaboration with Firstbeat Sports, we're going to be diving into TRIMP, training impulse, discussing how it's calculated and then how you can use it in a load monitoring perspective in team sports. So I've spoken before on a few previous videos about the difference between internal and external load. Now, as technology has evolved and we've got more insights from kind of GPS and other tracking technologies, a lot of the focus has shifted to external load, those distances, accelerations, decelerations, and speed metrics. But the internal load is important because it gives us insight into the demands on the body internally in terms of the physiological system. So you can see this figure taken from Franco Impedizzeri's publication, Internal and External Training Load, 15 years on in IJSPP. And Franco and his colleagues emphasize that it's actually the measures of internal load that indicate the actual psychophysiological response that the body initiates to cope with the requirements elicited by the external load prescribed by the coach. So it is the internal training load that determines the training outcome, the adaptations that we are seeking to achieve when we train, because internal load experienced in response to a specific external load varies depending on the different contextual factors between athletes, as some of these highlighted here in terms of their individual characteristics or their training or psychological status. And so it is through measuring internal load, such as heart rate response to exercise, that we understand the stress that our athletes had been exposed to. TRIMP, then, training impulse, as it stands for, is a method to quantify internal load. Now, it is based originally on Eric Banister's work in the 1970s. That is where a lot of the modern day training theory upon which we base our understanding of fitness and fatigue and internal and external load is based upon. So heart rate gives us a measure of exercise intensity. It shows us how hard someone is working. And then heart rate can be integrated with time to give us a measure of load. So we have our intensity, we have our volume, and then that gives us insight into the internal load that the individual is subjected to. So his research was based on an integration of time, intensity, and relative weighting of heart rate to give this internal load measure. Now, Firstbeat Sports have modified that into their current version of TRIMP, in which instead of using the mean heart rate across the whole workout, like Banister initially proposed, Firstbeat uses beat-to-beat heart rate data in order to give a more updated TRIMP score and one that better captures the variation within a setting. Now, this is really important as well in the more intermittent based team sports. So here then you can see the formula within which Firstbeat Sports currently use to calculate their TRIMP accumulation. There is an exponential relationship here then with exercise intensity. So you get a higher relative weighting for a higher heart rate. And then that is summated to give us our TRIMP score for a session. Another useful metric then is the TRIMP per minute score to understand the intensity at which an individual is working by dividing this accumulative TRIMP score by the number of minutes. And this is particularly useful if we're comparing perhaps different sessions or either different drills, because we have to remember any time we're dealing with an accumulation metric such as TRIMP, then very different sessions may get a similar score. So for instance, a very short but intense session that demanded high heart rate from our athletes may end up with the same TRIMP score as a session that was much lower intensity, but over a longer period of time. So Firstbeat also provide these very general guidelines for what tends to be a easy, moderate, or hard training session, both in terms of the total TRIMP as well as the intensity, so the TRIMP per minute. But of course, it's important to understand actually in your own setting, in your sport, what different types of training sessions and drills demand from a TRIMP and TRIMP per minute basis. I would be looking to establish the averages across our different sessions, but also on a player-to-player basis, what their norms are in terms of TRIMP and TRIMP per minute, as well as then diving deeper into looking at different drills to try and understand the physiological cost of those. That can then help us with our planning processes in terms of trying to get the required physiological stimulus that we want, as well as ideally the mechanical stimulus through the external load information, and then close the loop with our athletes to monitor them on an ongoing basis to see their trends in TRIMP and also if there was any divergence from what we would expect. So now I want to introduce this clip from Minnesota Wild's Matt Harder talking in a Firstbeat webinar about how he uses TRIMP with the team. And I think he gives a really great demonstration here of his application of TRIMP in this case, an NHL team setting.
It's just, it's information to me, you know, like, and I use it in a ton of different ways, like how we're kind of saying, like, it helps me be sure of like the decisions or the communication that I'm engaging in, having these numbers and having this data to look at. And then you can see a trend over time. And then, like I said, when you go into a coach's office or having a conversation with a player, it's, I'm not bringing my own opinion into it. It's just like, this is the data we have. It's very objective. It's not my subjective thoughts. This is just what it is. So if a player's got a really high training load, like that's it. Like he's got a high training load. Or if someone's really low, because they haven't been playing a lot, and I'll communicate this to certain players if they're not in the lineup a lot, like, hey man, like your weekly TRIMP numbers really falling, like we're in the low 500s, 400s maybe, like we got to start doing some more work, whether it's on the ice or off the ice, but let's pick a handful of days in the next 7 to 10 days and like let's try to get some higher quality work in. Or if we're doing conditioning on a game day, maybe they already skated in the morning, but we're going to do extra conditioning in the evening because maybe the morning skate wasn't that challenging for them. Then I can tell that to them, like, look, we're going to do some intervals today where you're going to be hitting 90%, getting down to 60%. We're going to do 12 of those. And the reason we're doing that is we're trying to just get your training load up.
Another common way of using this information currently is to integrate heart rate monitoring with standardized submaximal tests. So if you can integrate a submaximal run that is always the same demand, so you are fixing the external load, and then track the internal load and the cost to do that work, that can be a way of assessing an individual's fitness over time without the need for additional testing. So here we have one example provided by Firstbeat, where we can see the trend in an individual's TRIMP per minute in this case, in response to a submaximal run. Now remember, that is a standardized run, so the variation is not due to a change in the amount of work required. So this peak here on the 26th of January in the middle would be something I would certainly look to explore further, because it seems to be a little bit of an anomaly compared to this trend of their individual TRIMP per minute in response to that submaximal run. So if you are incorporating TRIMP into your analysis, there are some really important considerations for how you are collecting data to make sure it is meaningful. First of all, we need an accurate maximum heart rate for all our athletes. As we saw with Firstbeat's calculation earlier, maximum heart rate is a part of that calculation, part of the equation. And so we need to try to collect that, which is not always easy to do because maximal testing is very rare nowadays. But we're probably most likely to see maximum heart rate achieved from our athletes in a game or a competitive situation, in which case you may then have to backdate the information to get accurate TRIMP scores. As always, the data is only as valuable as our care that we put into collecting it. So because TRIMP is a representation of accumulation over time, we need to make sure that that selected time period is as accurate as it can possibly be in terms of the start and end times for the period in question, whether that is the whole session or whether that is using the clip feature to be able to analyze specific drills or part of the session. So in summary, TRIMP, heart rate training impulse, is a simple but validated way that we can calculate the internal load by looking at the heart rate intensity and this accumulation over time. This gives some great insight into the physiological cost of a session or a drill to our athletes. I want to thank Firstbeat Sports for sponsoring this video. I'll put a link below to their website. So if you are keen to hear more about Firstbeat Sports systems, then get in touch and discuss with them. I hope you found this video useful and valuable. If you did, please like and subscribe so you don't miss out on another Sports Insights video coming soon.